Irwawi.
Learn about the amazing life of a little girl who grew up to use her gift of singing to help bring freedom to South Africa. The title of the story is Singing the Truth, the story of Miriam Makeba. Authors Bianca de Jong, Jade Mathieson, and illustrator Louwrisa Blaauw. This book was originally published by Book Dash in Cape Town, and now it has been made possible by Pratham Books Story Weaver platform. A long time ago, in the vast city of Johannesburg, a baby girl was born. That baby was me. My mom called me Miriam, Miriam Makeba. Mom was a Sangoma. In South Africa, Sangoma means a kind of therapist or a doctor, healer. Okay, so her mom was a Sangoma, but she also worked to make other people's homes neat and clean. It was hard for my mom to earn enough for both of us. She started selling homemade beer to bring in more money. The laws of the land said that selling homemade beer was wrong. The police sent my mom to jail for 6 long months. I was only 18 days old and needed my mom. So even though I was just a baby, I went to jail too. As a little girl, I loved to sing. When I was older, I helped my mom clean houses. Singing songs as I worked made the chores go faster and the days seem brighter. Singing made me happier than I can explain. I sang in my church and this made others happy too. Music has the power to bring people together. When we were singing, we felt brave and strong. People said my voice was a gift and my songs were special. I sang with other musicians and our music was heard all over the world. My home was Sophia Town, a place of culture and music. Sophia Town, a place where South Africans could make music in harmony and dance together. But the people who ruled the land at the time did not like this togetherness. Those rulers didn't want black and white people to be friends. I knew it was wrong to treat people differently because of their skin color. I didn't hide my beliefs, and so those people in charge wanted me out of the country. When I was singing in America, I was told I could never return home. People all over the world heard my story. My songs and my story helped many to see how there was no fairness in South Africa for those with black skin. I decided to go on singing and telling the truth about my country, no matter what. The world loved my music and I was welcomed in many countries. I won awards and sang for important people all over the globe. My life was good, but something was missing. I could not sing in my home country and people there were not free. Then a wonderful day dawned when Nelson Mandela became president of South Africa. New people were in charge and the unfair laws belonged to the past. I finally went home with new hope in my heart. After that, I could sing in a free, fair country. People of different skin colors could enjoy music together. I helped make this happen because I was brave and strong. I sang the truth in all of my songs. Kids, the story is over. But Miriam Makeba, who was also known as Mama Africa, she was a South African singer, actor. And with a great coincidence, we are releasing her story today on 9th November, which is her death anniversary. A small tribute from us. To listen such more wonderful stories, visit us at www.booksthatspeak.com. Thank you.